following the tradition of my cousin Steve from Australia, who has sadly died a couple years ago, I will be leading you on an exciting journey to find the rare crocodile, Crocodile canadianus. I sound like I'm lost or anything.
Yeah, you are! God, I'm leaving! I'm leaving you, man! Wait.
Today, I'll be leading you on an exciting journey to find the rare Crocodile canadianus. It is only found on the western coast of Canada during its breeding season. Now, I want you to look carefully. 10 yards away, right in front of us, is a 3 to 4 meter long mature Crocodile canadianus.
You serious?
Yes. Okay, so you shouldn't be doing this at home, but like Steve, I like to wrestle with my crocodiles to know them well. Ah, this is a feisty one. Oh wait. Look at this huge tooth I pulled out of this beautiful monster. It's really quite extraordinary.
It's a cone.
No, it's a teeth.
It's a cone. It's a cone and you were wrestling a freaking log. Put on your glasses, you doofus.
You see that? The amabilis fur. Here we have an amazing specimen of one of the finest coniferous trees in our very own BC.
It's not 50 meters tall.
We'll give it time to grow. I do have evidence to show that this is, in fact, is the Ampius amabilis. Look closely at this leaf. Over here we see the defining feature of two silvery bands on the bottom side of the leaves. And we also see that the leaves spread out in a spray-like fashion with the shorter leaves in the front and the longer leaves in the back. All the leaves are blunted on the edges and it is dark green on the outside.
Where are the cones, man?
Well, this tree has not fully matured yet, and I'm guessing it's not the correct time for the cones to be coming out just yet. Because this is a rather young tree, a lot of the defining features of a mature amabilis fir would be missing. For example, in a mature fir tree, we would be seeing silver barks showing on the trunk of the tree. But what really defines this tree to be Ampius amabilis? The real defining feature of this tree, aside from anything else, is that it does have a name tag, Ampius amabilis, here. That is our ultimate conclusion, that this, in fact, is the tree that we have been looking for in our long journey today.
Beautiful trees that I always see. Oh, I started wondering what makes them different. They got nothing on you, Sitka. Nothing on you, Sitka. Your leaves are stiff and sharp and needle-like, like green or bluish green and flattened, four-sided with two white bands on the top side. Your bark is thin, but that is okay. It is usually brown, purplish, or gray. You enjoy growing with a lot of other trees. Maybe one day you will grow with just me. Maze, let it just be me. Your seed cones are reddish-brown or yellowish-brown. They tend to enjoy hanging from the crown. You grow along the coastal band. I can find you in the fog belt, or the river stream floodplains. Your leaves are so well adapted to this weather. They got this waxy coating that makes them so resistant. Don't get me started, babe, on your roots and trunk. Trunks are so wide and they make you so stable. That's why all your relationships are all so stable. Your trunks give you the stability you need to be with me. When I see your leaves, there's not a thing that I would change. Cause they're amazing, just the way they are. Hey there, Douglas Fir.
You are a large tree, you're really tall. 85 meters on the coast, 42 meters in the interior. And mature trees have a long branch tree trunk. Your leaves are needle-shaped, they pierce my heart. The upper surface is greenish yellow. Your cones turn gray when they're mature. You are the best thing that occurs in nature. Douglas fir. You're really good for furniture. I love you cause your wood is hard and thin. Douglas fir. Your needles are so pointy sharp. They penetrate my lonely, broken heart.
My leaves are nearly flat, glossy and soft, like a pair of lips. Yellow to dark green on the upper surface. Whitish underneath, yeah, the silvery length, so flat, flat, flat. My cones are quite small. They have the green, red, purple color. They turn brown with days. I rip and grow along both east and west coast ranges. Nothing is dark brown, reddish brown. It comes again strongly to me as I age. I am the Western Hemlock, don't you ever forget. If you ever forget, I will make you regret.
Dirty bit. Dirty bit.
Until